87% of the 840 million people live without electricity. And do you know that 3 million people like clean cooking tools and technology? They use wood, coal, and then that's for heating and cooking. They still use not clean fuel. And on average, 2.3% less energy was needed to create this $1 of economic output each year. And this is data show that in the world, only 7.5% that use clean from renewable energy. It means that, and the rest is still using the unrenewable resource, energy. Next, and this is the target of the indicators. The target is about, it's around 5, and the indicators is 6. And from the first one, ensure universal access to affordable, reliable, and modern, actually this energy service. And the indicator is proportion of population with access to electricity. And also the indicator is proportion of the population with primary reliance on clean fuels and technology. And the second target, increase the substantially the share of renewable energy in the global energy mix. It means that in the previous presentation show that only 70%. Only 70%. So it's hope that this target, it hope that the presentation is more higher and higher, of course. And the indicators, renewable energy share in the total final energy consumption. And this, we will give the example of Indonesia. Double of the global rates of improvement in the energy efficiency, and for the indicator is energy intensity that measured in the term of primary energy and GDP. And the two last target is enhance the international cooperation to facilitate access to the clean energy, research and technology, including renewable energy, energy efficiency, and advanced and cleaner fossil fuel technology, and to promote investment in energy infrastructure and clean energy technology. I will also try to correlate to the in the context of Indonesia also. For the indicators, international financial flows to developing countries in support of clean energy research, development, and renewable production, including in the hybrid system. And the five target is expand infrastructures and upgrade technology for supplying modern and sustainable energy service for all in developing countries, in particular least developed countries, small island developing countries, and landlocked developing countries in accordance with their respective programs of support. And for the its indicator is investment in energy efficiency as the percentage of the GDP and the amount of foreign direct investment in financial transfer for infrastructure and technology to the sustainable development. And this is the situation. The situation in the world related to the affordable SDG sub number 7, affordable and clean energy. As we can see that main country in Japan, I think with the Japan is its score is 78.9%, for Indonesia is 73%, and for Pakistan here is 55%. I don't show you. Can you see that? Okay, just kidding. And that's the situation. And this is about the share of population with access to electricity. This data is coming from the 2016. And we have in mind, this data represent the electricity access at the household level. And countries that considered as the developed by the, this category by the UN and classified as high income. That's there was that electrification is 100% from the first years the country entered this category. In Indonesia, actually, this it has achieved around 97% actually. This is 97%, but it's not categorized developed and high income, because this data show actually 1990 and in the